The black-footed ferret was once believed to be extinct, but thanks to critical conservation work and a little bit of luck, this incredible species has been rescued from the brink. Unfortunately, there are only about 400 left in the wild. In order to protect this fragile population, scientists first need to find them. We're back in Montana, this time visiting the Fort Belknap Indian community, home of the Ani and Nakota tribes. I'm with canine field specialist Melissa Steen and Tule, one of the best black-footed ferret finders in the business.
So she's basically going from hole to hole, sniffing for the presence of a black-footed ferret.
There she goes.
So what's that behavior mean?
So when she sits, she's telling me she's found something. Yeah.
So these are actually the burrows of prairie dogs. From 2 to 10 feet into the earth, all snaking and twisting and rooting together. And there's potentially a black-footed ferret here taking advantage of the presence of prairie dogs because they depend on prairie dogs.
Prairie dogs are a keystone species. Approximately 150 other species benefit or depend upon prairie dogs for survival, especially the black-footed ferret. Tragically, in the 1900s, widespread habitat destruction and the arrival of a disease called Sylvatic Plague reduced the population by more than 95%. Without prairie dogs, the black-footed ferret almost completely disappeared. The few that remain here at Fort Belknap are some of the last on Earth.
So what we do now is we are going to flag this hole. Really?
Girl.
Then I'm gonna take my GPS and mark this spot, and that will help inform where they send people out tonight to help look for the ferrets.
So the next layer of this incredible conservation project with black-footed ferrets takes us to the spotlight team.
Darkness falls quickly over the prairie, and I'm teaming up with Shammy Anderson from Defenders of Wildlife.
Shammy, just kind of going over the horizon with this spotlight. And what are you looking for?
Yeah, I'm scanning the prairie for what are green eyes. The sheen of the ferret's eyes are green. They look like emeralds. And they're close to the ground, dipping in and out of the prairie dog burrows. It's sort of like playing tag.
Finally, we find a black-footed ferret.
All right. So this is where proof is in the pudding. The black-footed ferret only survives in this subterranean community of prairie dogs. Now, do you just put in the front?
Just straight out like that, yeah, correct. And then you want to kind of cover it with the blanket, and then we'll take a GPS reading.
Okay, so waypoint is saved. The trap is set. This creature, for all intents and purposes, it was extinct. What happened?
A dog named Shep and on a ranch in Metitzi, Wyoming, found a dead black-footed ferret on the property and brought it home to its owners. That's how we realized it was no longer extinct.
But as irony would have it, soon after discovery, disease came and wiped out most of those surviving ferrets, didn't it?
Yeah.
What caused this collapse, Shammy?
It's Sylvatic Plague. When we see these prairie dog towns start to decline because of plague, ferrets quickly blink out. So if we can keep plague at bay, ferrets are healthy again.
All right, my friends, an hour has passed. I'm gonna check our trap. Look, furry little body. The hatch is closed. We've got a ferret. All right, to the camper.
We take this precious ferret to our field station where biologist Jessica Alexander will collect vital data and administer a life-saving vaccine.
All right, what's the plan, Jess?
So we're going to move this ferret into the induction chamber.
Okay.
So set it down right here
okay. So
it's lined up with the front, the end of the trap.
Okay.
And then just push it down a little so there, perfect.
Is that
so
good?
It's all lined up. Yep, and we're going to take this blanket off. There he is. And then sometimes they need a little encouragement. Yeah. I'm gonna back straight in, and I'll let you know when to close it. All right, clear, close it. Perfect.
Are we closed?
We're closed.
Oh my gosh. This is a species that actually officially became extinct. But now
not through some sort of miracle, but literally through blood, sweat, tears, and science, we've brought this species back. All right, let's put this beauty to sleep. We're gonna anesthetize the black-footed ferret while it's in this holding container. Because this is a creature that is clearly very sensitive to other diseases, they're vulnerable to the flu.
Right, exactly.
Influenza.
Yes.
So because of that, we're wearing masks. We take every protocol, every step necessary to keep these creatures safe, because every black-footed ferret matters. For this species to survive, everyone is a player.
Okay, I think I'm going to take him out and just slide him out of the induction chamber. That's... Jeff carefully put his head into the mask. I think that's perfect.
So by doing this, we're just keeping that constant flow of anesthesia, the exact safe amount, so our little black ferret stays sedated, so it's comfortable for this procedure.
We first give it some eye drops. Then we take a temperature, and we determine that he's a male.
So the next step is to give him his pit tag.
We place a passive integrated transponder called a pit tag just under his skin so he can be identified if he's ever captured again for conservation research.
It's just like what you would use with a dog or a cat.
Next, this little guy is given a vaccine that will help it fight the deadly Sylvatic plague.
So where are you going to put that in?
I'm going to put it underneath his skin right here on his hindquarters. So this is the very important one.
So plague is wiping out a lot of our ferrets.
Mm-hmm.
It's spread by rats and prairie dogs through fleas. It's a plague that's been haunting species and human beings since the dawn of civilization.
Right. Finally, we get his weight.
So here he goes.
So males will be a little bit bigger than a female.
Yep.
By about 10%, but this is a young guy.
Mm-hmm.
There's so many amazing species we get to work with, but for me, as a wildlife biologist, this is kind of like the creme de la creme of North American species, isn't it, Jess?
It is. Most endangered mammal in North America. If you'll hold the kennel for me,
yep.
I will put him in.
He's waking up.
He's waking up, which is how we like it. Okay, there we go.
Okay, awesome.
So he'll just relax, and then he'll get to go home.
It's just after sunrise, and several vaccinated black-footed ferrets are ready to go home. We're reintroducing them back in the exact same prairie dog burrows where we discovered them.
Reflector marks the spot.
That's correct.
There we go. Come on. Let me see. Oh, there went. Good job.
Chief Andy Work knows firsthand the importance of this creature to this tribal community.
It's really important for our culture here, for the two tribes, you know, in the circle of life here in Fort Belknap and in Oni Nakoda country. And they were here before, and we're glad to reintroduce them again. I'm really excited about it.
John Hughes from the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service is also here to lend a helping hand.
We're putting an animal here so that, you know, future generations can see it, and we literally saved it from extinction. And tip the kennel up just a little bit more so it hopefully goes into the hole. Oh, had a runner. Okay, let's back up. And what's important right now is don't pressure her. All right, see?
All right, there she goes. That was awesome. Thank you so much, John. Thank you, President.
Thank you, Jeff.
This is the spirit of what Wildlife Nation is all about.